She saw something flash out the corner of her left eye and then heard a small, dull thump. She set down her cup and hauled herself out of the chair, squeezing her belly awkwardly around the table's edge. And she hauled on a shawl against the spring air and waddled to the back door for the first time that morning. For days now, she'd watched the pair dart in and out the eaves, and glancing up, she saw at once the nest was gone. Her eyes flickered to the ground, and it was scattered in the gravel, pale grey tufts of down spinning towards it in the breeze. Oh my God, the fledglings. Five of them, four utterly broken, smashed up wee dinosaurs, and worse yet, one twisted but still alive, its heart continuing to beat. An impossibly huge red heart in such a tiny, scrawny body. And then it was over. She stood there and wept, wept for the fragility of life, tumbling out her own unspoken fears for the creature she carried within herself. She wept for the incomprehensible effort of that same swallow pair, how they'd flown from the Orange River Delta in South Africa, across the Congolese rainforests and the desert skies of the Sahara, up to 200 miles a day, and then whipped in over the Atlas Mountains of Morocco and skirted the eastern edge of Spain and Catalonia, Almira, Valencia, Barcelona, traversing the Pyrenees and the full length of France and England, only to see their nest and their brood fall from the worn stippling of a Midlothian farmhouse cottage for the second year in a row. The poor swallows. They're the birds in old Nordic lore who attended Christ on the cross, crying, Svala, Svala, console, console. They're the birds of consolation itself, and there was none to be had. She lumbered to the shed, fished out a handsaw and a hammer and some nails, and hauled a battered crate onto the bench. It was a labour, right enough, reaching across the expanse of her own midriff to secure the joints and measure the angle of the roof. It was a ragged affair, yes, but it was a birdhouse nonetheless, a sanctuary. Have you ever held something until your hands were aching and then let it go and watched it fall and listened to it breaking? I have held back time and tide when all the world was plenty, but now my hands are open wide and empty. For every breath that leaves me now, another comes to fill me, and for every death that grieves me now, I swear the next will surely kill me. For those borders crumble every day, the fault lines are showing, and all I thought was here to stay slowly is going. And history